Welcome back to the Caddy Diaries. We're on the way to Norway. Now, we left Ireland last night and our flight was delayed. We were meant to fly at 9:20, but didn't actually fly till 20 past 12, so I wasn't home till 1:30. So we had like less than 10 hours to clean all our stuff, get it all sorted. I've done a little bit of coaching this morning too, get all prepared, and now it's 6 p.m. and I'm on the way to the airport again, meeting Tom and another player called Ben Eccles. So it's three of us flying out to Norway. We'll actually get there at about 11:30, so it's a hell of kind of near enough going to be 12 hours of travelling with a little bit of home and getting stuff clean in between. But I guess the only good thing of us actually kind of being delayed at the airport, we all could kind of watch the USPGA. And oh my god, what a finish by Justin Thomas. I mean, yeah, he kind of did, well, he did what he needed to do on the last hole. He chipped it out of that rough, got it onto the right half of the green. And if you're watching this now, go and check out my analysis of Justin Thomas and how he played that final hole and why he did what he did, because that rough is super hard to play out of. So like I said, on the way to the airport, catch you when we land. Good morning guys, just heading down to the course to do some practice.
One of par threes this week. T is back here. It's like an island green. Looking class. Run off down the side, which is really cool. Like at this golf course this week. So we'll look at the 10th this week there. Par 3, 219 yards. All you've got to do is basically land it on this right off the green and it'll end up at the flag there. Playing into wind today. Just play the pro-am. Just walking out to play. We've actually played the back nine, sorry. And I'm just walking out to show you guys a bit of the course.
Last night, we got in so late. We didn't get to the actual house till probably, the hotel till 1 in the morning. Now, after all the travelling and the delay the last day, it was such a couple of long days travelling. Then we were up pretty early to catch the bus down to the golf course. So, we're absolutely shattered. So, Tom's just gone inside to get a coffee. I'm going to walk the course and then I'm going to do some putting as well. So just walking out now, like I said, and it's just started raining, so I'm going to show you as much as I can. By the way, this golf course is, I know I said last week, one of my favourites, but this is definitely up there. I like the heather, I like kind of the feel of the trees. I just got a good feeling about this week again. It plays into our hands, it's quite wide, you've got to drive the ball well. There's not many of those drives that we kind of play our low and medium ones. It's definitely a lot of kind of bombers off the tee and hitting those spots nice and high, getting the ball carrying as far as we can.
Just approaching this green, guys. So, you know I said that spot, and you'll see exactly why in a minute, why you have to be on that right-hand side. I'm going to throw you a ball now. Watch where these two end up. All the way down there. So to any kind of back flag that's over this bunker, we can definitely play to a spot just in here, so we can basically minimize our risk, play to our spot, and definitely maximize our chance of hitting the green. Look back from the tee, so anything we landed around in here.
Just walking up to one of my favorite holes here this week, the 11th, and I'll show you why in a minute, because they've actually got a second tee which makes you can drive the green. But look at these, you can't quite see them, the little daggers. Really, really cool kind of thing. It's like, it's called a Viking Challenge event, so it's a really cool little touch from the tour.
11th, par 4. That's it in the book. So you can either play into this spot here, which we did in practice on this tee, which leaves you probably about an 8-iron, kind of 9-iron to the green, depending on the wind, which is heavily guarded on the right with this water. So, but as again, like on the last green, you can play out left and let the ball roll down to the right. So there's definitely ways of still getting close to the flag, but being conservative. But this is why I like this hole. This tee up here is where you can go, because the hole is just down here. So this is the one we're going to play up. Definitely probably at the weekend, which then makes it a very much a drivable one, which brings in the water on the left and on the right near the green off the tee. This is how we know how far to the front. Metres and the yard. But also, if you look at this part of the book here, minus 37 from all the numbers. And this is kind of the area here, up the left or into this part here on the book where we're going to be playing, which is just down here. If I keep walking forwards, guys, you can get a better look of where we're going to land if we go for this really intimidating tee shot. Just this little spot here you can play into if you're hitting driver off the tee.
So the front edge you saw on that yellow writing was 300 yards, but we worked out that it's 15 yards downhill. So that makes it 285. So if any of you guys kind of wondering where, sometimes like, oh, where, how to get downhill, uphill, it actually says in the book, and that's a great little tip. So if you've ever got a shot that goes downhill, it's gonna play a little bit shorter than the actual yardage that comes up on your Sky Caddy or your Bushnell. This hole's a prime example of risk and reward, because even if that tees up, you can definitely still lay up into that bit where we, like I said, on the back tee, into the kind of red dot yellow cross area, which is conservative, or, like I said, you can hit the driver and go for it, which you're gonna gain a lot, because you're gonna have like, literally a lob wedge to the green. I thought I'd bring out one of my newer jackets this week as well, and I'm glad I did, because it's absolutely freezing compared to what it has been. Last week in Ireland was really warm, but this week is really, really cold. Just approaching the yellow dot, which gives us 176, but we're going to lay up a little bit past this off the back tee. We're going to go to the yellow dot or just past it, the red dot or just past it, just there, approaching it just now, which is actually a blind tee shot. And all we need to do is land it up here, and it's going to roll down. So we've been on this spot all week, we have this shot left into the green, which again is a very slopey green. Back from the tee, exactly, you can't see the tee at all, so this is where we're going to lay up from. There's that yellow cross, which was our max off the tee. Now the reason for that was, it's 300, but also it's kind of taking out this water on the left, because you're going to be running it from the right. So it's the most conservative play, with here was the shortest shot in. So if I just continue walking, I mean, there's so many different ways you can play this, but I'm going to show you this way we're going to play in the book, and it's probably the most sensible but smart at the same time, because we're taking on the water, but at the same time we're getting as far down as we can. So I know I said we could hit driver. You can hit driver into this area here, or in the rough of the left, but you'll see in a minute how slopey this green is. It's a cool effect. I love the heather too. Like you saw on a lot of the other holes, there's a lot of runoffs. And you've definitely got to be kind of sensible. Even though the greens look massive, it's a few bits that roll off and kind of fall into certain areas and runoffs, which can make it very difficult. And the greens are actually probably smaller than they actually visually look from the fairway. So again, light the 10th, watch this ball. They're gonna end up right down the bottom. So there's definitely more than one way to get close to these flags at the back. But it's a very, very fast, tricky chip from up here, and with this on the right-hand side, which is dead. Look back from where you've got to drive it to. That forward tee is just here, driving it into this area here. Do you know what my favourite thing about this golf course is? It's that usually kind of long golf courses like this, there's not much strategy involved, but like I've just shown you on the 11th, there's so many different ways to play it, and a lot of strategies take place. Yes, the fairways are wide and soft, which makes them even wider. You've got to be on the ball with strategy, because there's a little bits of water that run in, the rough's quite penal and thick hay stuff, which you can see over my shoulder. So you've got to have your strategy down to a tee, you've got to drive the ball well, but also be smart in some of the greens, because they're playing very, very firm. We're not quite sure how they're playing so firm, because the rest of the golf course is soft, but they're definitely playing quite firm. So to chip two, you've got to be so careful you don't leave yourself above the hole. Finally guys, I'll show you the 9th hole here this week. Bunker on the right, this bunker up here, which is short of the green, so an uphill second shot. Strategy this week on this hole. Our strategy on the 9th hole this week. So guys, our strategy on this hole this week, you can see I've got a max written down there. That's taking this bunker out of play here, and leaving us about 160 something to the flag, to a middle flag, which is just up here on the top edge. But this is going to be our conservative play, take out this bunker, very narrow section here, and plays the biggest, fattest part of the fairway. Giving us 151 to the front, which is just that bunker on the right hand side there. So 3-iron into this spot here, giving us 151 to the front, taking out this bunker, allowing us to get to this green, which as you can see is very, very slopey. There's our numbers from earlier. What club we hit, what wind we had, where the flag is, 22, horn, 15 from the left. That piers. So guys, just approaching B, the shortest bunker, which is our max, and the green is just up that hill there. This was B, which was 255, taking out this bunker. Very, very narrow in here. With the right wind, you can go in that area there. There's your B, taking out that. Playing to the fattest part of the fairway. T is right back there on the right.
uphill shots the second. So
to lay up that spot on the 9th, it is about 240, 255. So depending on the wind, that's going to probably be mostly 3 iron. Or if it gets into the wind, you could hit 2 iron either, but it's definitely just playing to that biggest, fattest part of the fairway, leaving us the best chance to get to that ball. It's the best chance to get to any of those flags because it's a very slopey green. So like I said about the shot playing shorter if you're going downhill and take yardage off. If you're playing uphill, definitely add a few yards because the shot will definitely play longer. The ball's not in the air for as long. So a lot of times, I see a lot of guys when I'm actually coaching at home, they don't take enough club uphill. Don't take into account that it could be 10 yards uphill. So say you had a 160 shot to the flag, that's actually really 170. So it could cost you a few shots, and that's just course management. That's one thing out here these guys do very, very well. One thing that me and Tom are very good at, course management, playing to our strategy and maximising our chances.
Quick look back down the 9th there, guys. Pretty long par 4. The layup short, that bunker you can see just there. And you're playing to a raised green. Look around. Found it. Really cool look to this golf course this week. Very, very cool.
Going to use this little backstop on the back. It's going to roll back to that flag. Definitely used. So guys, just to tell you a bit about my and Tom's situation. We've got to do well this week to get into the Rolex. So basically next week is the Rolex event, and that's guaranteed money. So we've probably got to finish top 5 this week to play our way into it. So fingers crossed we can do that. Good evening, guys. So just got back to the room, grabbing showers, heading out for something to eat, and then if I feel up to it, if not too tired, I'm going to head down to the gym, do a little bit of a workout this evening, because apparently we spoke to other few players and we got a really, really good gym again this week. So that's 2 in a row where we've had such a good gym. So may as well take advantage of it, go head into that gym and get some work done. Just heading for dinner. So guys, it's 10 p.m, we've just got back from dinner. Absolutely shattered after all the travelling of the last few days. Absolutely stuffed after dinner as well. So instead of doing the gym tonight and knacker ourselves out, we're gonna go tomorrow morning, head down to the course late and finish our prep late Wednesday afternoon.
Good morning, guys. It's 9 a.m, so I'm just heading down to breakfast. I feel so much better after a bit of a lie-in. And then we're gonna head down to the gym.
Just one glass of orange juice now. So hard to do it out here. It's so easy to go to breakfast and get a big fry up every morning, get pancakes, but I'm trying so hard to keep it healthy.
Right, never played it before. Let's be having it.
No, I don't want to lose.
United fan by any chance? Yeah, so after the first round, you're 2-0 to you. I'll go. Oh, it's horrendous.
That was terrible.
Simmer. Flush on the 4.
So that, how many do I have then?
You've got 5 there, and you had 2 before. So 7.
You're on 7.
Oh, 7-7 down to the final one.
So guys, on the way to the gym, found a cool shuffleboard. Now, I've never played it before, but a seriously competitive game. Unfortunately, didn't win. The team was going to take that crown.
High one now. No, but like, pretty much. I don't reckon, how far's the final flag?
I'll just hit a full one now, forgetting everything. Oh, like 3/4 of full.
how much it rained last night. Practice facilities are here, mint. Team was on the cake, hitting a few.
Really? So guys, as you saw, we did some of our prep. You saw the pitching and the chipping. So we worked through all the kind of different roughs. So thick rough, sort of like the medium cut, and then on the fairway. So we've done some really good work on the short game and pitching, which will be good out there this week. Did some putting on the range work, which unfortunately didn't see, but we've had a really good session just finally drilling some positions and getting the swing feeling solid. So feeling all prepped and ready for tomorrow. So guys, just finished in the gym, as you saw, absolutely quality. Did a bit of legs, bit of back, and a bit of core too. And I did that rower, so on the rower I did 5 sets of 100 meters and only 25 seconds rest in between. Horrible, but gets you warm, gets you warmed up. So, heading back to bed now. It's pretty late down here. Good evening guys, so just heading back to the room now after dinner. It's 9:30 and we are off at 8:50 tomorrow morning. So we're all prepped, done all our preparation and ready to go. So by the time this vlog goes out, you'll be able to check on the Challenge Tour website how we've gone on. So as always, don't forget to hit the subscribe button to keep up to date with not only the Caddy Diaries, but course vlogs, course tips, and so much more to come on Alex Elite Golf. Thank you for watching. See you next week.